Welcome to this instructional videotape on successful venous imaging. I'll be walking you through the venous imaging examination step by step. During the past few years, the art of venous imaging has been fine-tuned to include the entire venous circuit. Its accuracy has been proven in study after study to rival that of contrast venography. I think it's fair to say now that venous imaging is becoming the standard diagnostic examination for detection of venous thrombosis. During this presentation, we'll cover several key topics. First, we'll discuss the ultrasonic appearance of thrombus-free veins. What does a normal vein look like on the screen? What are its normal dynamics? It's here that the key to venous imaging is demonstrated, the complete collapse of a thrombus-free vein in response to light probe pressure. Next, we'll contrast the appearance of normal thrombus-free veins with that of thrombus-filled veins. We'll answer questions like, how can I be sure if there's a thrombus within the lumen of a vein as opposed to artifact? We'll also talk about characterization of the thrombus. After discussing what a thrombus-filled vein looks like, we'll cover pitfalls. We will identify several non-vascular structures that may be encountered during ultrasonic examination that may be mistaken for thrombus-filled veins. Next, we will address the challenge of finding and properly identifying each individual vein. In this video, we will utilize a unique approach to demonstrate the anatomy. We call this 3D anatomy. Using the 3D anatomy model, we will demonstrate the external landmarks that the examiner can use to find the major vessels. We'll then be ready to go through the actual examination step by step. Here, probe position will be shown simultaneously with what the examiner will see on the screen. Internal landmarks will be pointed out to keep the examiner oriented. After the regular grayscale examination has been demonstrated, we'll cover the additional information that can be obtained by adding color. The addition of color brings with it its own set of pitfalls, so these will also be briefly discussed. Finally, we'll address the topic of accuracy. Studies will be cited comparing the accuracy of venous imaging with that of contrast venography. Now that we've outlined what to expect, let's proceed.